The year 2017 has been all about breaking stereotypes. So what does it really take to be a fashionista right here in our beautiful Paradise Isle? Let's find out today on The Hangar. Today on Walking Tall, we have one of the iconic names in the Sri Lankan fashion industry. We have with us here today, Ramona Oshini. How's it going, Ramona?
Hello, I'm fine, thank you.
How has your fashion journey been so far? I mean, leading up to the year 2017?
It's been a long journey. I launched my collection in 2010 at Colombo Fashion Week. And I would say it's been a roller coaster. You have your good days, you have your bad days, but it's been good so far.
What would you say is your proudest moment in your fashion career so far?
There's been a few, but I would say the most memorable would be launching of Zadora. With my partner Chani Suryege, and also launched my brand in 2010.
And speaking of 2010, that is the first time you launched your brand in, you know, Colombo Fashion Week, which means you've been in Colombo Fashion Week. You've been a part of Colombo Fashion Week for a consecutive of 9 years, right?
Yes.
7 years or nine times.
Yes, that's right.
Crazy. That's a lot of times. And what do you think about the fashion industry, like, ever since the growth of the fashion industry over here in Sri Lanka?
I would say Sri Lankans have always been fashionable. It's just that they didn't have places or designers to create something for them. So they used to always go and buy from abroad. But I'm proud to say right now there are so many Sri Lankan designers who are creating wonderful clothing, and Sri Lankans are coming back to us and wearing whatever is truly Sri Lankan.
And speaking of, you know, being truly Sri Lankan and all that, considering your work that you've done so far, I want to know about your latest collection and what it came into being, like how it came into being.
So the collection we are working on, actually we work on different collections as capsule collections. So there are different influences for little collections to always keep our clientele interested. But at the moment I'm working on something with the greenery surrounding us, so it's foliage, different prints of foliage, mixing up green with different kinds of brighter colors. To talk about green, you know, and how Sri Lanka is a tropical country, and I think that's a lovely color to work with.
That's absolutely right. It's a small paradise island, but yeah. You can work so much with it, right?
Exactly.
So that's where you got your inspiration for the latest collection.
Yes.
That's amazing. From so far and so many collections that you've come up with, like to now, what a great, great thing to have, like you in our industry. So thank you so much for being with us over here. I want to get into what you think about, you know, fashion, and what is your ultimate fashion tip for those of you, those of the designers, the young designers who want to be just like you.
I would say to all the up and coming designers, I mean, there's a long way to go. I think it's always been humble and creating what you love, but some people come into the industry thinking popularity is everything, but it isn't. There's a lot of hard work involved. And if you work hard, you're going to get go places.
So we have a shoot happening today. You're going to be showcasing one of your collections. Could you tell us more about what we're going to see?
This collection includes more of kaftans, a lot of easy breezy dresses, which is flirty but very feminine. So I want to, enjoy this tropical country and, you know, like people to wear what is suitable for the tropical atmosphere. So.
Where do you look for your inspiration when it comes to, you know, every single year there's something changing? Like this year there's a lot of, you know, controversy going around, breaking around stereotypes, right? Breaking stereotypes. What do you think is changing in the year 2017 in terms of fashion?
I would say, for me, I look at trends that is happening all around the world. It is a guidance for me, but I try to maintain my Sri Lankan blood and get inspired by what is Sri Lankan. And so we incorporate a lot of batik, a lot of hand lace, a lot of crochets. This is empowering our artisans at the same time, which is a dying breed. And so incorporating that into my designs is something that keeps the world interested. So it's me standing loud and proud. I'm Sri Lankan and this is what Sri Lanka has to offer.
And where do you see Ramona Oshini, your brand, going in the future? Where does your ultimate goal take you?
Well, ultimate goal would be to have my stores everywhere in the world. But at the same time, what I want to do is make a change in Sri Lanka with the up-and-coming designers, possibly have my own university, fashion university. So there are many goals, but We take baby steps,
that's true. And you've come such a long way, so I want to know, what is the one lesson that you always carry with you in your heart until now as a fashion designer? What is one thing you picked up?
I would say working with the industry and being very humble, because I think the industry needs each other, and you have to have that, you should help each other out, and because our industry is so small, so it should build up together. So that is my guidance to everybody.
Can you tell us a little about your experience at the Asian Fashion Week?
Asian Fashion Week, I took part in 2014. Actually, that is organized by Kalam Fashion Week as well, where they encouraged us to take part for that. And it was held in Indonesia, which is beautiful. And it was a great experience because we met other designers from all over Asia, and up to today we keep in touch and help each other out if they needed something. So it's been a great experience, and it was a great moment for us to represent Sri Lanka.
So thank you, Ramona Oshini, for being with us here on The Hanger. We are really excited for you and see what you're up to next in terms of your fashion and the collections.
Thank you very much. Do.